Hey folks, how's it going? Things have been a bit busy lately, but I finally have 5 minutes to take a good look at this 6 Bertedro set. One quick warning before moving on, should you decide to spend money on the game to buy it, try and wait for as long as possible before doing so, and make sure that whatever banner the character you choose is from is either over or not going to appear. Too many times I've seen people getting one character from the Anithix and then a gold moon of that character a few days later. Some patience can save you from that salt Everest that Duke can bring. Now, I don't usually advocate for spending money on free-to-play games, Granblue being my only exception, but I come from the era of subscription-based MMOs, Ragnarok Online, Lineage 2, World of Warcraft, and that's pretty much what Subtixes are to me, except they also come with a character of my choosing. The Anniversary one is the only one that's going to allow people to pick limited characters, Grand Series characters, or limited summons though. These sort of characters are usually worth saving up and sparking for, and the possibility of picking one up for 3000 yen is a bit too good to pass up on. So let's head over to the wiki and see who's available. The first pool I want to take a look at is the Grand Characters one. As powerful as they are, these characters are always sparkable in the middle or at the end of the month, and this time around we'll have the roulette going through both and with the guaranteed 100 draw on Legfest. From the Flash Gala pool, the availability stops at Shiva, so Grimnir, Jahn and Shalem are out of the picture. All the others though would still be great picks. Personally, I would recommend the Magna 2 Primals, Lucio, Vira and Orchid, the last two also coming with fantastic main hand weapons. Black Knight is an all-red tank, but Dark is chock full of great characters. Zoe has kinda been falling off the meta and her weapon still doesn't have a 4-star. Sturm and Drang are both nice but not irreplaceable and come with some core weapons for their respective primal grades. Olivia is a character that I haven't used or seen in a while, her Fallen Sword is core for Stamina Hades though, but if you're using your Anithix to bolster your primal grids, you already know what you're doing. These characters will come in the pool around the 15th of April, and you might be able to get some from the roulette, so if you're aiming for one of them, make sure to wait until the Flashfest is over before picking it. For the Legfest characters, coming out on April 1st, the availability stops at Folia, so sadly, Fairy, Monica, Noah and Ray will not be available. These characters are a bit of a weird bunch, they're not as prevalent in their element as Magna 2 Primals for example, and many of their weapons got replaced for their primal grids. The ones that shine a bit more than the others are probably Catalina, who became really nice after her 5-star, Lashia, Kane and Folia. Weapon-wise, Rosettas, Yugens, Lashias, Kane and Folias all see use in their respective primal grades. Again, the roulette will end on April 1st and the ticket will last 24 hours more, so if you're picking a grand character, make sure to do all your rolls beforehand. The next banner to take a look at is going to be the summer one. Last year we got two summer character rate-up banners on the 14th and the 16th, with the Flashfest beginning on the 18th, coming with the release of Summer Yule. The following banners were just standard elemental rate-up ones. This year is going to be Tina's turn, but if you're going to pick a summer unit with your Anithix, better wait for April 21st after the Flash Gala is over, and we're sure there's not going to be other summer units in the pool. As for the characters themselves, they're all up for grabs. Some of the better ones include Vira, who became insane after her rework, bringing Dispo, Delay, Strength, a nice heal on a red skill, instant charge attack gain and a charm. Noise, with his 20% charge attack damage cap for all allies. Greya has been falling off a little bit and requires a bit of maintenance for her buttons, but still has a really nice damage output. Halwell and Malwell come in playing with Crests and Echoes, also running around with a self 20% boost to damage cap. Summer Sandalphone looks really good on paper, but I've never really managed to get him to work, preferring to run other units in his place. Summer Keg comes with a guaranteed critical hit trait, more damage cap and a keen buff. She actually looks insane if you can feed her enough deluge crests. Summer Europa also comes in as another water buffer, with some crits and echoes as well as a very powerful single ally buff. Looking at her cooldowns though, I think I would prefer Summer Cagliostro over her, but I have neither so I can't really be sure. Summer Jessica looks cute and I wanted her for some Earth Gun memes, but I wouldn't spend an Anithix on her. Summer Anthuria, on the other hand, looks perfect for more dodge memes with Biki, being able to constantly extend her buff duration thanks to multiple sources of charge bar gain. Lastly, Summer Alex becomes even more a tank and loses her 30% increase to Earth attack. I'm sure she can work fine in some real hard content, for example the Water Dragon Advent coming out, but I'm not a big fan of her kit, and like for Summer Europa, I prefer her base version. So there's quite many potential picks in here, my favorite ones being Vira, Grea, Cagliostro and Anthuria. Let's also keep in mind that we are already in March, the summer season is not that far away, so I would either choose to put my hands on Summer Grea or Cagliostro to have a better time during the next Guild War, or skip the summer characters altogether. Next up, the Halloween ones. October is already a bit further away and I've never been a big fan of rolling on the Halloween banner, both for its limited pool of units and the fact that it's too close to the New Year's celebrations. Most of the characters are also not that great, the main attraction here would be Halesena if you like crazy risky plays or simply have a death wish, and Lady Grey coming in with an AoE Strength Onogi, a 5-on-7 turns uptime drain that also boosts the charge attack spec slightly, and some general survivability. Personally, Lady Grey has been my first SSR and I've always had a thing for redheads. She would have been one of my top candidates if my ticket was not already promised to someone else. Then there's the holiday characters. This one won't appear in another pool until December, so spending a Soptix on one of them cuts away almost a year of waiting. And even though their banner has a few more units as well as much juicier ones, it still comes during the roulette and right before the new Zodiac release, so I'm a bit reluctant to spend a spark there. As for the character, Mary is plenty cute, but her kit doesn't really seem all that powerful anymore. Metera actually looks quite nice, bringing in a multi-attack buff and increased charge bar gain. Magisa looks quite busted, granting Wasteland Crest, charge bar boost and reactivating her nuke plus Dispel Onogi. She also gains some real insane self-buffs, or even just grant a 15% charge attack damage and a 5% charge attack damage cap to the main allies if she's in the backline. Meteon is actually alright even with his limiter, he gets enough damage from his amplification and extra nuke to stay on par with other attackers. Cyrule feels kind of weak, but I'm almost sure he's going to be core in some win-favorite Guild War or Proving Grounds, where the fight starts and your characters get inflicted a skill seal on turn 0. And then there's Narune. Missing out on her has been the biggest disappointment of the whole last roulette, and she also comes in with an 8% Echo and a quasi-assassin skill. Her and Luchador are going to shred raids. Lastly, the one banner that's actually going to take a year to come back is the Valentine one, but both Grimir and Skatesha are unavailable, so there's only 3 choices there. Medusa looks a bit weird, she's got a nice 50% bar boost and a boosted CA specs for all allies, but this only gets activated after an enemy special attack, which she has a chance to inhibit with her own stealth stiff debuff. Melissabelle got recently reworked and turned into a skill damage machine gun. I've seen people do some insane counters on the Guild War EX Plus, but she needs to be hit a lot and therefore only works against some specific bosses. Then there's Valentine Clarisse, coming in with Veil, Mirror Image, Charge Bar Boost and extra effects activating from the 10th turn onward. She's a bit awkward for short fights, but she's proven to be an absolute monster in longer ones, packing so much utility it's crazy. So the final candidates for the anniversary ticket for me are going to be Europa, Alexiel, Shiva, Lucio, Vira, Orchid, Lesia, Kane and Folia. Summer Vira, Naois, Grea, Cagliostro and Anthuria, Halloween Lady Grey, Christmas Magisa, Meteon and Narmea, and closing with Valentine Clarisse. If I had to remove characters I wasn't 100% sure about, the remaining ones would be Europa, Alexiel, Shiva, Lucio, Vira, Summer Vira and Cagliostro, Christmas Magisa and Narmea, and of course, Valentine Clarisse. But I did make a promise last Christmas and it's time for me to keep my word.
ナルメアサンタさんだよ。とっておきのプレゼントあげよっか。目を閉じても伸ばす。私の名前を呼んで。団長ちゃんとなら。この思い届きますように。記憶の花今もまだ消せない。眉たれの誇張求めるものがその先にあるなら、きっと過去の身を導いてほしい。
Alright, and I'm done here. Let me know if the video was any helpful, and I'll see you guys soon. Ciao!